Okay, guys. Well, let's start. Once again, welcome to you all. And also, I would like to first introduce ourselves to you. I'm Arjen, and this is my colleague, Anita.
Hello.
And we are working for BGB Dentistry. And I also see that there still are people coming. So I also will admit everyone over here.
Shall I do it if I see that there are more people coming?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So about us. First, we help European dentists to come to the Netherlands. We started a few years ago, I think around 2011, with this program because we in the Netherlands have a big shortage of dentists. And that's also why we've created a program to help dentists from abroad to start a career in the Netherlands. And that's also where this webinar is about. I and also Rita, we would like to talk about what you should know as a Portuguese dentist who's still in Portugal or still studying or even sometimes working in Portugal if you're thinking about a career in the Netherlands. And that's also why we have selected a few subjects that we would like to discuss in this webinar. What you can see also over here is also the index of this conversation. Well, actually, the introduction I just did. By the way, I haven't told you about where we are located, by the way. We are logically in the Netherlands, and we just moved from our office in Amsterdam to our new office a little bit in the north of the Netherlands, in a very typical touristical part of the Netherlands called the Zaanse Schans, with the typical mills and also the picturesque houses over there. And that's also our new office since a couple of weeks. Hopefully, we can invite our dentist again if they would like to join a program in the near future by showing them a little bit around of this area. So it's also you or maybe also other Portuguese dentists can have an idea about where we are working and also how the Netherlands also look like. Guys, also what you can see here in the index and what I would like to discuss and also what Rita would like to discuss as well. I will tell you in the beginning something more about why can you think about going to the Netherlands. Furthermore, a big subject and also a question that I received quite often from dentists who I speak to is why is there a Dutch language exam and how does the exam look like? I will tell you also more about that. Continued by telling you something more about the program what we have, the BGB program, and also the way how we guide dentists like you into the whole program. Furthermore, I will give the word to Rita, in which she will tell you something more about her experiences as a Portuguese dentist who moved to the Netherlands some years ago. I will really think that, because I'm a Dutch guy, that from the mouth of a real Portuguese dentist, that is always, of course, even nicer to hear, because that's also something similar what you have with your own nationality. So she will tell you something more about how she experienced everything here in the Netherlands and also how she started her career in the Netherlands in our country as well. Then she also will tell you something more about what you should know about working as a dentist in a Dutch dental clinic. What are the differences compared with Portugal? And also what should you know if you start working in a Dutch dental clinic over here? And then finally, we'll continue about possibly next steps. And also we have, of course, time for questions. I also just discussed it also with Miguel, but if also you guys have questions in the meantime, so after every subject what we are discussing, also don't hesitate to send us a message in the chat bar, and then we can also discuss them right away. Please let us know if you can also hear us clearly. Is everything correct until so far? If you can type something in the chat bar, that would be great, because then we also know that everything works fine. Check. Yeah, well, I think that everything is going well so far. Great. So let me again add some more visitors.
Oh, that's very good, very positive.
Also nice for you guys, because we can see how many people we are watching at the moment. I think we are right now counting 81. So
that's here plus 14.
Okay, maybe they have still both links okay. on, can be. So guys, let me continue first with what you should know about the Netherlands and why the Netherlands could be an interesting country to think about. Let me then, because sometimes the presentation doesn't work. Yeah, correctly, now it does. Why the Netherlands? It's good to know that the Netherlands has almost like an opposite situation that you are having in Portugal. In the Netherlands, we have simply not enough dentists to fill the vacancies that dental clinic have to provide work in the Dutch dental clinic. So in other words, now patients have more difficulties to find a dentist who can help them with a dental treatment. And this is something what is already facing and what we already are experiencing for several years. So we started already in 2011, and around that year, we saw that there was a big shortage of dentists in the Netherlands. So we thought like, okay, if there are not enough dentists in the Netherlands, so not enough graduates every year, because we're a very small country, as you, I think, probably know, we don't have enough graduates every year to fill all the possible vacancies that are around. That's why we are obliged to look for dentists abroad in other countries to fill the vacancies in our country. And that's why we started many years ago, around 2011, again, with Spain and Portugal. And that's also a little bit like the transmitted in our company name, because BGB is actually the abbreviative of Buena Gente Buena. It's a little bit, yeah, Spanish, Portuguese sound. So we also thought, and also we saw that dentists in the beginning from Spain and Portugal adapted very well in the Dutch dental clinic. And that's not because we are talking to you right now in Portugal. No, but we really have seen good, we have had good experiences with dentists from Portugal and also from Spain. So that's also why we wanted to give this webinar, because we really think that it could be interesting for you to know about starting a career as a dentist in the Netherlands. So that's why, because of the shortage of dentists, it's also that directly a good reason why you can go to the Netherlands, because there are a lot of job vacancies around over here. So big difference with Portugal, what you find and what you're encountering probably at the moment. It's quite difficult to find maybe a good job or a job full time or where you can really do everything what you would like to do as a general dentist. That's the opposite in the Netherlands. So here you have a lot of vacancies, and we can guarantee them also a job over here to work in a Dutch dental clinic.
And a salary.
And a salary as well, even important. And here in our country, in the Netherlands, also people go usually twice per year to the dentist. Well, at least that's also recommended.
Yeah.
I have to say that my own girlfriend doesn't follow that advice, but okay, I usually do. And I think also the majority does. And that's also what you can see in your agendas. The agendas of all the dentists who are working here in the Netherlands have a full agenda, so you have a busy day every day. So I don't think that you have a lot of time to check all the time your Instagram feed or something, or your social media. You have quite an agenda every day to follow. And that also makes it quite challenging, and also a nice day to work in a Dutch dental clinic. And that's not only doing a checkup or only a filling, it is also doing other treatments, like endodontic treatments, prosthetic treatments like crowns and bridges, implants. In the end, it's good to know that Dutch patients, that they expect that you give them the optimal treatment, and they are also willing to pay for that. Therefore, every citizen in the Netherlands can decide if they would like to insure themselves for dentistry or not. I, for example, I have quite a healthy mouth, so I decided to pay my costs on my own, from my own pocket. But people who know from themselves that they have more problems with the oral situation, they can decide to insure themselves for dentistry, and then also the insurance will cover the majority of the costs. Because in the end, the patient always listens to the advice, to you, the expert, who is in the end giving advice about what needs to be done in the mouth of the patient. So then it really doesn't matter if it's going to be a crown or a bridge, if that is really necessary at that moment. And that's also then in summary, I think why the Netherlands can be an interesting country to think about, because you can do a lot of treatments within the general dentistry. But although that you have a busy day in the clinic, you only will work max 8 hours per day. So that also makes it pleasant and comfortable regarding your personal work-life balance. So you're working every day 8 hours, but then afterwards you go home and then your personal life starts. And you see your partner, you see your husband, your girlfriend, boyfriend, if you're single, you go outside. Right now, that's maybe not the right time with Corona, but usually you can go to the gym, you can go outside, go to a bar, etc. So you can also have a good work-life balance here in the Netherlands. And there's not only working every day, there's also time for yourself. And also in the weekends, usually you're working 5 days per week. That's also good to mention as well. Sometimes there will be an emergency shift what you have to attend. So keep in mind that once per month or once per quarter or once per half year, it really depends on the clinic where you're working. And you have to sometimes take the emergency shift, but that logically is also then compensated in your agenda the week before or the week after by an extra day off, for example. So in general, the work-life balance is also something I think where the Netherlands can be an interesting country to think about, besides also having professional development as well in the dental clinic, and it's also you're gaining work experience. It is maybe cliche, but now maybe it's also an interesting subject to mention, because also it's a safe country. And although I think in the whole world we're living right now in strange, uncertain times, especially right now with the COVID situation, I do still think that the Netherlands is a safe country where you can totally feel comfortable regarding ethnicity, your sexual identity, genders are accepted over here, also religions, there are several religions over here are totally accepted. So you never have to worry what you believe and also where you're coming from, what kind of sex you have. So that's also, I think, also another reason why the Netherlands can be an interesting country to think about, that you can totally feel comfortable over here. Also, what I've heard a lot from dentists who are right now working here in our country is that they see over here in the Netherlands quality of life. I do think that quality of life is subjective term, because quality of life can be different from every person. But I do think that a good work-life balance, a safe country where you're living and working, but also unpolluted airs, I think as well.
A decent salary,
good job conditions. So you are valued, and good, and also well recognized as a healthcare provider. What I also hear a lot from dentists from other countries is that they say, yeah, I'm working in the clinic, but I hear that my patients, they prefer to be treated by the older dentist in the clinic because he has more experience and not by the younger one. Well, that is usually not happening over here. It's in the end about the quality what you make as a dentist. So it really doesn't matter then if you're a 25-year-old, a 24-year-old, or 35 or 45-year-old. It's in the end the treatment what you offer to the patient, and that patient feels comfortable with that, and that he also will come back for you or to the clinic 1.5 year after for the second checkup of the year. And also what you read over here, guys, as well, as I already mentioned before, we also have a good experience with Portuguese dentists. We see that also the level of education what you have gained in your country is from a good level. And also that regarding mentality and also your adaptability in adaptation in the Netherlands, you also won't need that much time for that, to really relocate to a new country, to feel yourself at home in your new country. Well, I think later also Rita will tell something more about it as well.
Learning the language.
Learning the language, exactly. And we also see that I don't know why, but we really see that you guys do well about that. And that also it's definitely possible to learn our language, and also that you will, yeah, I don't want to say that you feel like a Dutch person almost, but that you feel quite fast already comfortable in a new country. I also saw of all the dentists who are right now watching this webinar that already a few of you also, we are already in contact with each other. But for the ones who don't know us yet, I also have written an article some time ago in which we have highlighted 12 reasons why you can consider a career in the Netherlands. You can find it, I think it's right now quite high in Google, but you can also find it, of course, in our at our website, but also in my personal profile, LinkedIn, Instagram, etc. But otherwise, later I also will share our contact details with you. So if you also would like to know more about working as a dentist in the Netherlands, and also why it could be interesting to think about the Netherlands, feel free to let me know, and I always can send you the link to this article. Guys, questions so far about this subject, why the Netherlands? Do you have some specific questions about this? Also, maybe something nice, or maybe nice to tell you something about Corona as well. I like how the whole Corona situation right now is happening in the Netherlands. Yeah, I think that's also something where we are living in together, all of us, and every country has, yeah, more or less their own policy of dealing with this pandemic. I do have to say that. Okay, maybe we are not that well regarding the vaccination because for some reason we are quite slow, or we're walking behind with rolling out the vaccination in the Netherlands, but now we are making a sprint, and I think also we're going higher again. Also regarding relocating to the Netherlands and also in this COVID pandemic, of course, it's all about safety first. Yeah? So we only do our things, and we can only continue our activities if it's, of course, allowed to do. And that's also why we always will ask in the end for a negative COVID test, logically, yeah? So you can travel. But if for some reason your government or everyone else decide that it's impossible to travel, then we'll find, of course, another solution, and we'll find out what we can do afterwards. But in the end, it's also our concern to think also about that with you together, obviously.
There's a question.
I also see that Barbara has a question, and she asks, like, do you need any kind of visa to work there? Well, it's good to know that we are especially working with European dentists. That's not because we are very cherry picking or something. No, it's more about the legislation what we have. Because in order to register yourself as a dentist in the Netherlands, we need a European degree and European nationality in order to do so. So that's why it's also not necessary to have a visa, because that's the advantage of the European Union where we're living in. Living in Europe and also working in Europe is also possible. So if you are relocating from Portugal to the Netherlands, then you don't need a visa, and you can do it easily also with your Portuguese passport. So you don't need a visa to relocate to the Netherlands. And if you're outside Europe, then it's different, of course. I do have to be honest that we are not that specialized in that area, because then also dentists from outside the European Union, they have to follow a totally other way of process, which is way longer and also way more complicated. So then maybe you also definitely need a visa, and also apply for a work permit as well. And the residence permit at the same time. But that's also not our expertise. So we are really focusing on dentists with European degree and European nationality. But if Barbara, if you still have more questions about that, feel free to send us a message, an email later also. So we can also give you some more information about that. Okay, next subject. Yeah, here it is. Then the Dutch language exam, because thinking about going to the Netherlands is one thing, but then really doing so is a second thing. And in order to start your career as a dentist in the Netherlands, in the end, you also need to be registered as a dentist in the Netherlands. I think it's also something what everyone would like to do, because in the end, you would like to feel recognized, respected as a dentist in the Netherlands. So in the end, every healthcare provider in the Netherlands will have a number, registration number, which shows that they are registered and recognized as healthcare provider in the Netherlands. So that's also why it's very important to have it as soon as possible. However, in order to start your registration in the Netherlands, you first have to pass a language exam. And the language exam is an obligatory step in order to start your registration. As you can see in the slide as well, it's not, unfortunately, level A1 or A2 or B1 is higher. It's level B2 plus in Dutch. So it's quite a high, almost academic level. And it's definitely possible to learn so. But of course, you really need to feel motivated and be motivated to learn a language. That's also why we have designed and created the program to make that possible for you. That also comes later. But that's also why it's an obligatory step to first pass a language exam with us in the Netherlands before we can start your registration as dentist in the Netherlands. In the end, it's not only about the Dutch language. That's, of course, the majority of what you need to learn, obviously. But also it will be about dental vocabulary. So in the end, in the language exam, you need to be able to act like a dentist, and you are doing a role play with an actor who's then acting like a patient, and you have to explain in detailed Dutch what is the diagnosis of that patient and what kind of treatment plan will you propose to the patient. So it's, as you can imagine, quite an academic and high level of Dutch what you need to have. But again, don't worry too much, it's definitely possible, and that's also why it will take some time to get you on the required level what you need to have. About us, and it's not a very cheesy commercial promotion from us, not at all, but we also are right now a recognized language institute. So besides helping you with everything also what you need in order to start your career in the Netherlands, but I also will explain in more in detail in a bit, we also are recognized as language institute, which means that also we are allowed to offer you the language course, but also to offer you the language exam, which is recognized and also registered as official exam in the Netherlands. So with the result that you get from us at our language course, we can use and send that result to the Dutch government, to the Dutch health system, in order to start your registration. And it also, of course, is the same in case, in the worst case scenario, that you won't pass right away for your language exam. Then we will keep helping you with more classes until that you will get the required level of Dutch. But at least we do know where you are regarding the level, and we can offer you an exam again, recovery exam, maybe a few days later, or if you need some more time, a couple of weeks, a couple of months later. But I also will come to that also in a bit. Questions about this, the Dutch language exam?
No.
No, I don't think there are questions for now. Well, guys, let me then also directly make a bridge to the next subject and also our program. So everything what I just said, like thinking about a career as a Portuguese dentist in the Netherlands, and then first learning a Dutch language, starting registration as a dentist in the Netherlands, but also, of course, finding a job in the Dutch dental clinic. And we thought, okay, how can we make this possible for dentists like you to restrict the amount of time which you need to have of leaving your country behind, learn a new language, and start finally, in the end, your new life and your new career in the Netherlands. That's why we have made a program in which we can invite our dentists to join our program, and in which we can prepare you at the best way possible about everything that you need to do and need to arrange in that short period of time. So in fact, what we would like to do is to help you with all the necessary steps in which you can think, okay, what should I have to arrange if I would like to leave Portugal right now and I start my life over there in the Netherlands, like paperwork, finding a job in a Dutch dental clinic, inscribing myself in the Dutch system, applying for a health insurance, of course, what Reed already said, like, yeah, earning a salary in a Dutch dental clinic, everything about that. And also, what kind of clinic will fit with the profile what I have? That's also the expertise what we have built up in all those years, last few years, and also why we have seen many dentists also coming to the Netherlands, also Portuguese dentists who are right now all working here in our country. But the first step, as I already mentioned before, and I think what's already quite obvious, is to learn the Dutch language. And that also will be then done through an intensive Dutch language course. And the language course will be a part online, what you can follow totally at home, and a part offline. So the first steps, the first steps of the whole program, you will do it at home. And in the first 5 weeks, you will have an e-learning course, which will take around 30-35 hours per week. So it is something which you can combine maybe with other activities that you have. For example, your work in a dental clinic, or maybe with a course which you're attending, I don't know. So it's definitely something to combine with other activities at the same time. But there will be 3 classes per week, which you need to be available of, logically, because we also have to make an agenda with our teachers as well. And there's also a lot of self-study. So we'll give you access to a platform where you can make exercises, but also we can give you also, of course, all the theory which you need to learn about Dutch grammar, etc. And as well, our teachers are available 3 times per week also to practice with you. And you are practicing together with another dentist who's also in the same situation as you. So also we will always try to make couples at the same time. And you will see that you make progress already quite fast. So in the first 5 weeks, you will normally reach level A1 in Dutch. So in just only 5 weeks time, you can see how fast it goes. After that 5 weeks, there will be a new block of 5 weeks. Again, you will still follow up at home. However, that's more intense. It's like a full-time block. So something you can't combine anymore with your work, what you still have maybe at the time. You really have to dedicate your time to learn the language and to really focus on doing that e-learning part. Because then in those 5 weeks, you go from level A1 to A2. And in the meantime, our Portuguese colleague, Dario, I, by the way, also just wrote an article about him recently, what you also can find at the website nowadays. He also moved with his wife, a dentist, a couple of years ago to the Netherlands. And he's also working with us, BGB. And he's also nowadays also your guide in regarding the paperwork and also helping you and guiding you in this whole language program. And he also will help you then with arranging some documents. So meanwhile that you are busy with learning the language, in the meantime, Dario will help you to arrange some documents like a certificate of good conduct, but also, is the connection still okay?
Yeah, but it's the battery on this computer that was dying.
Ah, okay.
Sorry.
Okay, no, don't worry. A birth certificate which you need to have, obviously, I think around the time, a negative COVID test as well. So to be sure that you are totally healthy as well. Few things that speak for itself, but Dario also will guide you through all that. Because then, as you can see, guys, on the slide, then you will study and continue the language course abroad. And we offer that in our hotel in Austria. It's in Seefeld, very close from Innsbruck, by the way. And there, we invite everyone on one fixed location, like creating a bubble.
Big brother.
And like to speak in this pandemic time, so to create a bubble and to stay there in one fixed place. To offer and to continue the language course also over there. And there you will go from level A2 to B2 plus in the end. And there, I think also the nice part about it as well is everything is totally arranged. So you have your own private accommodation, your own private room. Food and drinks are included, are served every time.
Breakfast, lunch, dinner.
Breakfast, lunch, dinner. Of course, maybe it's nice to have sometimes a Portuguese night, Portuguese delights. Pastéis nata, for example, yeah. I don't know. You also are not alone. And I think also the nice part about learning the language on location is that also you will meet other dentists as well. We have seen many friendships arising by also meeting other people.
Relationships
as well, of course, as well. But it's also, I think, very nice to have people around you who are in the same position as you, preparing themselves for going to the Netherlands. And I think it's also a very nice way of not being alone over there, but already have friends around you, other dentists around you, where you can share experiences with. To learn together over there the language. At the same time, our colleague Rita, will be there. Someone doesn't have, I think, the mute button. Now he does. Yeah, perfect. So besides everything which you need to know about the Dutch language, we also, after 5 weeks, will incorporate a dental vocabulary course in the language course over there. Because first, as I told you before, you first need to know the basics about the Dutch language. But after a while, when you have a certain level of Dutch, then also you will learn the dental vocabulary about how to say root canal treatment, extraction, everything then in Dutch. Because that's also an obligatory part what you need to show in the Dutch language exam afterwards. Besides, it's not only learning Dutch, and Dutch. In the end, of course, you're all dentists, and that's also why. Rita, usually before COVID, she went once in a while to Austria to do the course face-to-face, in person over there. But now with Corona, and also the fact that she also got a little one herself as well, we did it also online. So nowadays, she also will then present also a webinar or a video in which she will tell you something more about how dentistry is done in the Netherlands. So everything which you need to know about, okay, what is the hierarchy between the manager in the clinic and the employee, but also what is the role of the assistant, which you have in the clinic. All those things which you need to know about starting your career as a dentist in the Netherlands, like a prep course. And although it's intensive and you go to class all the time, I see that also as a question. I'm sorry, I don't understand this point. Is this intensive course for those who don't know anything about the Dutch language? And does it then habilitate you to start practicing in the Netherlands? Yolanda. So in fact, this we will start from level scratch, level zero, with our language course. So you don't need any knowledge of the Dutch language. So gradually, you will go to a higher level in Dutch. Of course, it's applicable to dentists only. So we will give you all the tools, all the materials, what you need to have and need to learn in order to make a process and also at a higher level in Dutch, gradually by block for block. And then after 4 blocks learning, because again, it's 10 weeks online, what you already have done at home, you also will go 10 weeks to Austria, again, divided by 2 blocks of 5 weeks. Gradually, you go to a higher level in Dutch. So you start with level zero, and after 20 weeks learning of Dutch, you will reach level B2 plus in Dutch. So you don't need any entrance level of Dutch what you need to have in order to join our course. By the way, if you do have, let's say you already have been learning Dutch on yourself, and you already have a certain level of Dutch of, let's say, A1 or A2 or B1, logically, then you don't need to follow all our blocks of the language course, but then you can maybe enroll in one of the other blocks, which are way further in the process. And therefore, we all the time can do an intake with you to find out what level of Dutch you have. And then we can determine together in which block you can enroll our program. But that's something you can always discuss personally in a personal conversation. Between those 2 blocks, when you are in Austria, there's also a break, because otherwise you will like brainwashed totally. Okay, thank you very much.
Okay,
great, Yolanda. So of course, there's time for relaxing. And although that you are busy every day, yeah, we're learning the language. Logically, there's time for going to the gym. Well, you are between the mountains. So
you're skiing
at the moment. That's also, I think, one of the advantages of being in the winter in Austria. But in the summer, of course, it's a very nice advantage to make nice walks, long walks and hiking. So it is really like a nice area. It's definitely not a big city. No, it's a very tiny village, only have a few bars, and even now, of course, they're closed. But it serves really well to study on location, to be there together with other dentists, and also, yeah, to have also a nice time together, and also to work on your own career and to reach the required level in a couple of months' time, a couple of weeks' time over there. What else? Because also the teachers are there. So it's not only that you are there together with all the other dentists, all the teachers are there in the hotel as well. And that's why we always make groups of between 2 to 8 people, not more, because we also would like to maintain and guarantee the personal guidance, what you get from the teachers. So what happens if the group gets higher, gets bigger, and there's still only one teacher, then of course, it could be cheaper for us to offer that, but in the end, it also would affect your learning curve and your learning process to reach faster the required level of Dutch, logically. So that's why we all the time secure the amount of people who can join our program. And all the time we make groups of between 2 to 8 people so that we can make sure that you can reach the required level in a couple of weeks' time. In the break, which you have between those two blocks, there's also time for doing some excursions. So once in a while, you will see that you will go with all the other students, all the other dentists, go for sightseeing, visit areas in Austria, or sometimes before, it was all the time, Oktoberfest. that's also a little bit difficult right now in these times where we're living in. But just saying that also, of course, there's enough time also to relax and to think also about other stuff and not only about learning Dutch. So in the end, there's also time for that. In the final week of the exam, the final week of the language course in Austria, in the whole last week, we will dedicate our time to practice exam trainings with you. So we'll practice all the time, like what can you expect in the exam itself? Ari can give you an idea. It's also, I already said before, there will be a part, it will be an exam where you are the dentist. And you have an actor, a patient in front of you. The patient has a complaint and you are making a diagnosis and you also have to propose a treatment plan. Also, you have to read an article about a subject in dentistry and you make also a presentation about that also on screen, for example, with PowerPoint. Or you just present a summary also in front of the camera. And also you have to make a summary about, well, again, about the treatment plan which you propose to the patient, also in a good level of Dutch. So as you can expect, it's quite something what you need to learn, what you need to know in order to pass the exam successfully. And after practicing the exam the whole week, you will have the exam on the last day of our language course. So actually before you will relocate to the Netherlands afterwards, and you will do that then also in Austria, the language exam. And hopefully, of course, we also expect that you will pass right away the language exam. And as I said already in the beginning of this webinar, we are also certified and also allowed to examine the exams ourselves as well. So we can also see right away if you've passed it or not. And hopefully, of course, yes, we can start right away your registration as a dentist in the Netherlands. And we can, of course, inform the clinic where you will work in, of course, as soon as possible about this good news as well. In case that you haven't passed, of course, you won't say, hey, sorry, you have to go back to Portugal again. No, of course not. But in that case, we do see where you are regarding your level of Dutch. So we also know if you just had a bad day and that you just missed the exam or that you just didn't pass the exam or maybe a few percentages. But if that was the case, then we can already offer you to do a recovery exam already ourselves, let's say maybe one day later, or even sometimes even the same day. But if we see that you really need some more time to reach the required level of Dutch, then in that case, you have more classes when you already will start your career in the Netherlands. Because it's good to know that you can work as a dentist in a Dutch dental clinic, but until at the moment that you're not registered yet, you're all the time working under supervision. And on short term, well, I think also Rita will tell you later as well, on short term, that doesn't matter that much, because it's also possible that working under supervision means, by the way, that it's not all the time watching a dentist above your shoulder what you're doing. That's not the case, but actually it means working under supervision that there has to be another dentist in the clinic present so that you are allowed to do your work. As you can understand, that is possible for the short term. However, for the longer term, that is not very convenient. So that's why we hope, you hope, and also the clinic hopes that you will pass the exam as soon as possible. And that's also, the name what we have built up in the Netherlands already since a couple of years, that we also are known as a language institute that also delivers dentists who speak the language and also are in the end registered as a dentist in the Netherlands. But again, it doesn't mean that you can't work. Yes, you can work, but then all the time, then keep in mind under supervision. It's also good to know, I will also tell you something more about that maybe in a bit, regarding salaries, that automatically you also get a small salary raise when you also will pass that exam. So when you have passed the exam and we can start your registration, you get a salary raise automatically once that you are registered as a dentist in the Dutch health system. But that's also, again, a reason and shows once again that being registered in the Dutch health system is simply valued a lot. And this is very important. There was a question from Antonio. He says, how high is the approbation rate of the language exam? Thank you. Good question. Well, the teachers who will examine your exam, so will value your exam, they know also what kind of level you need to have and also what kind of fluency you need to have in your words, what kind of vocabulary you need to have in your words. In the end, I need to be on level B2 plus. I'm not a teacher, Antonio, to be really honest, so I also never have, of course, examined myself an exam, but that is the exam what the teachers of every language institute, but also at our language institute, know what you need to have, and also what they can hear, and also what they can see by seeing your writing and seeing also hearing your speaking, if you have passed that and have proved that or not. And if that's also not the case, let's say in a worst case scenario, you won't pass the exam, you also will get an evaluation, of course, after that. So you also see why you haven't passed that yet and where you have to work on for your recovery exam. So you will see right away why you haven't passed yet. So sometimes it can lay very close from each other and that you haven't maybe passed it for a couple of percent, but you will see it right away when you receive the evaluation afterwards, obviously.
Can I add something?
Yeah.
Because the groups are small, you get immediately a feedback.
Yeah.
So it's not that it comes out as a surprise. If there's something that is not going as planned, the teacher will also tell you, right? And and you will work on that.
Exactly. So the teachers are still there. So at the moment that you are doing your exam in the language course in Austria, on the final day, you also see the teachers around you. So also the teachers will know right away if you will pass or not. And also they can give you directly, also what Rita said, the feedback, what you need to have and what you need to work on for later in case that you haven't passed yet. But to give you a comfortable feeling, guys, also we have seen Portuguese dentists passing right away the exam. So
In general, yes.
So it's definitely possible. Logically, it also goes only hand in hand with mutual motivation. So you can expect from our side, that's also what you can see in this slide as well, that you can expect from us guidance, collaboration, motivation, and all the tools that you need to have in order to do well in the course. So you can expect from us that we can help you and guide you with everything. But of course, we do expect from you as a return that you also dedicated to learn a language, that you will, of course, go to the classes, that you don't go skiing or go to the mountains, so that you really do well in the course. But that's also what you can see later also in the requirements, what I also will tell more about it. I also will come to about the requirements, what you need to have in order to do well in the course. Before we talk about the requirements, guys, let me first also finish this story about what else we can do or what else we do in this BGP program. So now we have spoken about the language part, the language exam part, and we hope then again that you will pass after that 20 weeks of studying. But in the meantime, that you have been studying in the language course, we have been busy for you to find you a job in a Dutch dental clinic. And a question what we all the time receive is like, can I select the location where I would like to work? And then I sometimes have to say, unfortunately, not really, because we preferably try first to search for the best match. The best match with your profile and what the clinic can offer to you. So that can be maybe a case that we'll find a vacancy that is totally suitable for dentist A, but totally not suitable for dentist B or dentist C. So that's why we all the time, I'm also the one who was doing that. So let's say you are interested in going to the Netherlands and you have some questions and you would like to know more about it, or you would like to start even better this process. And then I also will be the one, besides answering your questions, I also will make a description about you, how you are as a person, but also how you are also as a dentist. With that information, my colleagues and we also will try to find the best match for you in the clinic, what has a vacancy at that moment in the Netherlands. So it can maybe be the case that you will go maybe to the north, west, east, center, south. However, I all the time also will ask like, hey, have you been living in a city or a village? So if somebody lived in the village in a city, that of course it will be a little bit complicated if we also send you to a very isolated area where the first neighbors will live 20 kilometers further away. No, that's of course not what's gonna happen.
Let me tell you, it's not like in Portugal that you are going to live in a village that has 20 people.
No, exactly. We're not that small.
It doesn't happen like that.
No, and besides, living and working are two different things. Yes. So maybe we think that the clinic totally fits your profile is maybe located in a very tiny village. That doesn't necessarily mean that you have to work in that village as well. So what we do see usually is that people, they are working somewhere, but they live, let's say, 30 minutes away, or they go by bike to the clinic, yeah, or they go by car, or by public transport, or by train. And so living and working are two different things. So that's why, in the end, we would like to be sure that you have a good time in the clinic where you're working. So if somebody really says like, hey, I really prefer to work in Amsterdam, and then maybe we say, okay, why? Because in the end, if it's about Amsterdam because you like the clinics in Amsterdam, or is it you would like to work in Amsterdam because you really like the city of Amsterdam? So we try really first to find a good match where we think like, hey, this clinic has a good match also with you. And when we think that's the case, while that you are still learning with the language, we will present you to a clinic what we think that has a good match with you, like this. So online, you maybe will speak online with the manager of the dental clinic, so you can meet each other, ask questions, etc. Or like before COVID, it also happened quite a while, that's quite often that clinics also joined us to visit you in Austria, face-to-face, because then also you can meet the people as well over there, and you already can find out it's also a good match to work also with them as well. Yeah, now it's of course a little bit complicated, and now everything will be done online. That also works, by the way. Yeah, so we haven't had any problems about that by finding a clinic and only to do it online. That's not the case. So it's definitely possible, but hopefully if COVID, things will get more stable again soon, although we don't know it yet.
No, but
don't worry about that, because in the end, we can always schedule a chat also online. So then after finishing the language course, you will then start to work in the clinic that we have selected for you. By the way, if you have had a chat with the dental clinic and there was not a good match at all, that can always happen, obviously, don't worry. Then also we can, if you have logically good arguments, if you really see that's not a good match at all, then we will be able to find you a new clinic. But usually, I hope that there's also like a trust thing which you need to have, and we'll have faith also in the way how we work. We really take our time and to find you a good dental clinic. That's also, where we really take the time for, to find the right clinic also for you. And usually that results in a good match afterwards. So after finishing the language course, then already one day after doing the exam, usually you will go, or 2 days later in the weekend, you go to the Netherlands. And in the meantime, we already have arranged temporary accommodations for you. Temporary, because we don't know yet for sure if you're really going to stay over there. And because you will start in the beginning with an internship of 3-4 weeks, something like that, just to find out if you really like the clinic where you're working.
And the also, clinic as well.
Other way around, if also the clinic likes you as well. Again, it's a mutual match. And if that's a yes, from that moment, our guide, our buddy Nienke, she's also the one who helped you with arranging the accommodation and your installation in the Netherlands. For the ones who also have kids, finding a school, for example, for also the little ones. Everything and what you need to arrange when you start your life and your career in the Netherlands. She's also the one behind also to help you also with that. But from the moment that we know that you're going to stay over there, from that moment, we'll help you to find fixed accommodation. Regarding that topic, of course, you have your own style, which can be totally different than I have, that Rita have, of course. So we won't select your studio or your apartment, but we will help you about how to make an appointment with the landlord, to check your contract, for example, what you're renting, etc. So just to have an eye on it, to keep an eye on it if everything goes well. So also you can expect also guidance from that as well at the same time. About the temporary accommodation, what you have during your temporary internship in the clinic, by the way, you can expect like an Airbnb, so a temporary accommodation. Also a question from you guys, that I also received, like, do I also get paid in the meanwhile that I'm doing the internship? You more like get an amount of money from us, like pocket money that you can live your life in the meantime in the Netherlands. So around 250 euros per week, something like that.
To go to the supermarket,
to buy your food, etc. Because once that we finally know for sure that you're going to stay over there in that clinic, then from that moment, of course, you receive your salary. By the way, again, if in the end turns out that it's not a good match, logically, and then we'll find you a new clinic. Keep that maybe in mind. It can maybe take a few days, because in the end, again, it needs to be a good match. It need to be a good vacancy available around the time. So, but in the end, we also take the responsibility for you to find your job after all.
And it could be that the first place is in the north.
Yeah,
and
that also can be the case.
Yeah, in the south.
And that's exactly the reason also why it's a temporary accommodation and not fixed right away from the start, because maybe it can change already in a couple of weeks. I do have to say that usually it results in a yes. So usually you also will stay directly in the clinic what we have selected for you. But if not, for whatever reason, then it can maybe happen that it can be in other clinic afterwards. But again, also we will guide you through that program as well. Also, we see here a kickstart in the Netherlands by our colleague Rita. And beside the fact that Rita is also the one who's a very important role in our selection process, because in the end, besides the fact that she's Portuguese herself as well, she's also the one who has the best dental skills in our team, I think. So she knows very well, like, what kind of skills you need to have, and also what she will tell you later about in order to start your career in the Netherlands. She's also the one who will then have a conversation with you to find out if you're ready to go to the Netherlands or not yet. But hopefully, of course, it's a yes. But also she's the one, again, who will give you the dental training in Austria when you're there, but also the one who will guide you and like give you a kickstart and will help you with problems what you have in the Netherlands. Can you tell something about that, Rita? Otherwise, I'm all the time doing the talking over here.
Now I will talk in Portuguese.
Yes.
Olá a todos. Então é assim, eu faço na parte inicial, faço as entrevistas a nível do diagnóstico, fazemos uma discussão de casos clínicos, é um bocadinho para eu perceber qual é o vosso nível, a nível da medicina dentária. Quer dizer, eu tenho que perceber se vocês conseguem fazer um diagnóstico em condições, conseguem identificar uma cárie, quais são os tipos de tratamento que conseguem propor ao paciente. Eu não estou à espera que vocês coloquem implantes ou façam tratamentos ortodônticos, mas têm que saber, ora bem, este caso precisa de um tratamento ortodôntico, têm que enviar ao ortodontista ou não. Pronto, é feita uma, nesta parte inicial da entrevista, eu vejo o vosso nível de... Como é que vocês estão a nível da medicina dentária. Quando vocês estão em Seefeld, eu aí faço treinos individuais ou em grupo, conforme vocês me pedirem. Podemos treinar diagnóstico, rever protocolos, pode ser em português, no caso dos portugueses, ou em inglês, quando temos outras culturas, como é óbvio. E treinamos isso também em holandês. Isto porquê? Para treinarmos rapidamente a fazer um diagnóstico, como dizer e como propor um tratamento, e eu também faço uma espécie de roleplay, como é que reagem os pacientes na Holanda, porque depois também há esta parte cultural, não é? As pessoas são diferentes, reagem de uma maneira diferente, colocam as questões de uma maneira diferente, pronto, isso eu depois também vos ajudo com isso. O que é que vocês também recebem da minha parte? Todo o tipo de informação relativamente aos protocolos e guidelines que nós temos que usar na Holanda. O que é que se deve fazer nesta situação, na outra? Falarmos do software, o que é que vocês têm que escrever obrigatoriamente na ficha do paciente? Estas coisas mais burocráticas. Em que é que eu também vos ajudo em todo o processo? E não quero dizer que é no primeiro mês, nos primeiros 3 meses, no primeiro ano. Não, vocês podem contar sempre comigo, se precisarem de uma segunda opinião, rever um tipo de tratamento, vocês vão ter uma urgência, não sei bem ao certo como é que eu devo fazer, num trauma, tudo que seja relacionado com a profissão, vocês podem recorrer a mim, enviam-me um WhatsApp com um raio-x e podemos discutir isso, ou por mensagem, ou marcamos uma sessão semanal, ou uma sessão mensal, e eu ajudo-vos nesse sentido. That was my part.
I think I understood.
Yeah.
I think I understood I think almost everything.
Yeah. Okay.
That's also because I know a little bit of Spanish, so that's why. Okay, guys. Later also Rita will tell you more about, of course, her own experiences, etc.
Yeah.
To finish also this slide, as you can see, we have a 3-year guidance collaboration. So it's also good to know that it's not obliged to stay 3 years in the same dental clinic. Usually, we see that sometimes people also would like to go work in other clinic during their 3-year collaboration with us in the Netherlands. That's totally normal. You also would like to see how things work in other clinics. Also, you would like maybe to see things in other parts of the Netherlands. So it's also good to know that we will collaborate and we also will guide you for 3 years. But that doesn't mean that you have to stay really 3 years in the same dental clinic. It also goes the other way around. So if for whatever reason, you don't want to live or you don't want to work anymore in the clinic, or the clinic in the end doesn't want to continue with you anymore, whatever the reason also can be, don't worry, in the end, we also are responsible to find you a new job during the 3-year collaboration, also what we have. A question I also receive a lot, like, okay, what are the costs then? And also, what do I have to pay? Good news about that is that there are no costs for you involved, because in the end, we would like to help you to relocate to the Netherlands. And we also don't think that you are responsible for the costs that need to be made for something that there's a deficit of. So in the Netherlands, dental clinics are looking for new employees. So there's a shortage of dentists in the Netherlands. You are willing to put your efforts to study the language, to relocate to the Netherlands, to arrange everything what you need to do to start your career over here. So in the end, we also think that the dental clinic where you are working should contribute to the cost that we have to make for you to guide you in everything what you need to do to start your career as a dentist over here. So also what you can see, we would like to offer this program. So also then call it for free, but free in the sense of that the only condition what we do ask you is to work with us for 3 years, because in the end, we will finance your costs with the money that we also get from the clinic where you are working. So that's why we also have to ask you also to work with us for 3 years, so that we also can finance your costs in those 3 years' time. Regarding gaining a salary and also how it really works, like the whole structure where everything goes to, we really need, I think, a specific webinar about that, how that really works. So it's good to know. I will make a summary also about that. Okay, I'll answer it in a bit. So it's good to know that if you're thinking about joining our program in the end, you say, hey, I really would like to go for the longer term to the Netherlands. So let's say a minimum of 3 years, then you can think about a program. If you say, guys, I'm not sure, maybe I will like, I'm very young or whatever the reason also will be, I would like to see after every year or after every 1.5 year or 2 years what I would like to do next. Then with all respect, of course, with all due respect, maybe you are not that interesting enough. But if you are looking for like an experience for a few years or even sometimes longer, because I think that the majority is still living and working over here. But of course, that's very personal. And then I think this program can be very interesting because there are no costs for you involved at all. But then again, we need then a 3 year to collaborate with you so that we can finance your costs again with the money what we receive from the clinic. Again, I won't go really into details right now because I really need, I think, 1 hour extra webinar to explain everything, how it works in detail. But it's good to know that in the clinic where you will be working, we will take a percentage of the turnover what you make over there. And from that amount, we will pay your salary, what you will gain every month in the Netherlands. But we also will finance a part of the cost that we have made for you all before. So we actually cut our cost in 36 monthly payments, what we need to pay, of course, back. So that's also good to know why you need to also work with us for 3 years. But again, that also only will be happening from the money what you receive from the clinic while you will be working. So in the end, the clinic is also contributing to the cost that we have made for you. And also, we also take then also part to do your administration, and also that I get paid, that we get paid ourselves as well. That's also our income as well.
And the language course.
And yeah, that's also part of the cost, exactly. Yeah.
That was the question of Ileana.
Ileana, let me check. I haven't read the slide yet. This does not include the cost of the language course. In the end, with the money what we get from the clinic, we also pay off every month a part of your language course. So in the end, we don't ask you anything to pay back to us. So in the end, we pay everything back in 3 years' time with the money what you make in the clinic. So I already can say that the percentage what you are making in the clinic, we take 40% of the turnover what you make in that clinic. That's what the clinic will send to us. And from that, we will pay you out. First thing first, your salary, that's the most important thing. But also what is left, we take also a part also to pay off every month an amount for your language course. And also, it's not by the way only the language course, it's also are your flight tickets, the food and drinks, the paperwork, etc.
The hotel, staying at the
staying hotel, accommodation, etc. See like the total package.
And like then, an all-inclusive.
An all-inclusive program, yeah, exactly. And also then, finally, so that we also can exist and keep existing, we also need then a certain amount to have income ourselves as well. But that is more or less like the concept and also the way how we will work together in those 3 years' time in the Netherlands. Let me go back to the questions. Eliana was asking like, you say there's a 3 year commitment only. However, this does not include the cost of the language course, right? Well, yes and no, because the 3 years commitment also implies that you are working in a Dutch dental clinic in the Netherlands. And with that money, what we get from the clinic, you will get paid, but also our cores are get paid from that money. So in the end, the clinic is also in financing for the cost that we have made for you with that. Lisa was asking, is it possible to know the percentage I have to give you, BGB program, and the percentage I have to give to the clinic from the work the dentist does? Well, actually what I just said, like we simply take 40% of the turnover what you make in that clinic. And from that amount, we do everything. So to pay your salary, that's the first most important thing again, but also to pay off for your costs. You don't have to pay us anything. So it only will be done from the amount what we get from the clinic. Again, guys, in this webinar, I really need more time to explain how that really works then. But the summary, what you need to know is, in the end, we'll use the money what we get from the clinic where you're working to, one, to pay your salary, but also to pay off for your cost where you don't see anymore yourself, because we also will finance that at the background for you, but because we also have made those costs for you. So in the end, you just have to work 3 years in the Netherlands, and then automatically your cost will be financed automatically in the clinic where you're working. Let me check if I have more questions. Good question from Xenia. Hello, after we graduate, are there specific dates for us to begin the BGB program, or can we join anytime we want can? Well, that's already very well, it's a very good question, Xenia, because also you can see in the last slide over here as well that we have several groups per year. So I think every 2 months we have a new group starting. So regarding this year, we have a group that started in January with the course. In February, they will start, I think, next Monday. And also we are selecting right now the group of May, June, July, August, and October probably again. It also depends sometimes of the amount of candidates who are applying. Usually we see that the groups after the holiday are always higher than also groups, for example, right now in February, because that's also normal, because after the summer holiday, you're thinking about, especially for the recent graduated dentist, like, hey, I'm starting my career somewhere. What can I do? But also it's usually, I think, a good time to think about a new career in that time of the year. So there are several moments to join a program, and we can discuss together what is for you then the best moment to join. Let's say you have a conversation with Rita and he says, hey, for example, this time, Xenia, hey, you have a great profile, but maybe I should wait 1 or 2 months more. Maybe then you don't start in this group, but you start maybe 2 months later or maybe 1.5 year later. In the end, there's also regarding the requirements also that you can see over here. And also what we have made a specification about the normal requirement, but also requirements for recently graduated dentist. We also would like to be sure that you meet the requirements for our program. And what does that mean? Hey, you need first regarding paperwork, you need to have a European degree and European nationality, but also you need to have good language skills, because in the end, we would like to pay everything also for you at the background, but we also need to be sure that you will be able to learn our language and the way how we can value that. Of course, we are no prophets and we can't predict the future logically. However, that's also why, now Rita, of course, you spoke in Portuguese. I even can't do that, to be really honest, but not so fluent at least. I also would like to hear your language skills. So in the end, I also would like to hear how good you are speaking in English. Even better, there's even better advantage if you also know other languages as well, because that's like an indication that you also can learn other languages at the same time, or that you have the ability of learning a new language. And still then we don't know 100% for sure, but then at least that's a good indication that you have the skills in order to do well in our language course. As well, motivation and also good personality. So we would like to be sure that you are a nice person to work with, and that you are motivated, of course, to live and to work 3 years in the Netherlands, that you are motivated to learn a language, but that you also see the language something of like a nice challenge, and that you're not afraid also of learning a new language, that you really are confident about yourself, of that you can make it as well. Although it is something completely new, obviously. And that confidence is also something what I really would like to address to the rethink right away the dentist. And also what Rita is all the time telling to dentists she's talking to, who are right now studying, but also who are at the time or in the moment of, or in a situation of graduating at short term. You, especially as a recently graduated dentist, you need to show that you're confident about your skills. And we, and I am totally aware, of course, that you're still in the beginning of your career as a dentist, and that, of course, you haven't made the most advanced bridge or crown or implant, of course, at that moment. But at least regarding the basics, and Rita also will tell more about it in a while, the basics you need to be feel and you need to be confident about that. And I mean about, okay, doing a filling, making a good proper diagnosis of the patient, knowing how to do some periodontics, making an endo, making an extraction. So really the basics of dentistry. And again, I'm not a dentist. So in the end, I also would like to leave it also up to the part of Rita. But especially for recently graduated dentists, you need to perform and excel. You need to excel also, I think, in excellent in learning the language. So you need to show that you are able to learn the language, but also confident in your shoes. So we also have had one dentist. He's also one of our ambassadors, Joao, by the way. He also didn't have that much work experience yet, but he was so confident. He was so proactive in learning new things. And he also understood the basics. He had enough confidence about the basics in dentistry that he did well right away from the start. And also there are also several other dentists who also have been doing the same also like him. So confidence is really like the key and also the minimum what you need to have, at least as a recent graduated dentist to have, and if you start working as a dentist in the Netherlands. The time I've been speaking, I see also a list of questions. So sorry, guys, of my talking. Let me go. The salary from Vanya. How much will we get paid monthly after that we already have then received the money from the clinic? That really depends per profile. So what we now have is that we work with salary skills. So we have salary skills that can grow from 0 to 10. And depending on the outcome of the conversation with Rita, but also what we think, also what you are able to make as a turnover in the clinic, we will offer you a certain salary skill. I already can say that the salary skill for recently graduated dentist, because you're still in the beginning of your career, is logically a little bit lower than the one who have logically more experience. But the minimum start salary, you can also find it in our vacancy, by the way. The minimum start salary will be around 2,000 euros netto. But again, as I already said before, if you also will go, if you will pass the language exam, and also you will directly receive your registration, it also will automatically go to a higher salary raise, of, I think 200 euros, something like that. So then the minimum salary will be around then 2,200 euros. Again, it's not the most highest salary compared with what usually dentists are earning in the Netherlands, but still you are in the beginning of your career. So we prefer that you start slow in the Netherlands and that you don't have too much pressure on your shoulders when you are working in the clinic, because your turnover in the beginning also won't be that high, probably.
I would say the first years
is adapting, and you have to know, and you have to learn a new culture. You have to learn to know your colleagues, working with a full agenda. That also takes quite some time to learn that. And that's also what we also know in advance, and also what we can inform the clinics about. So that's why we will start with lower salary skills, but we have a biannual evaluation. So we can find out how you are doing in the clinic. Are you happy over there? Are you still happy with your life in the Netherlands? Are you still happy with the clinic? But at the same time, we also have seen how you have been doing in the clinic. And usually, well, I think also you know as well, you will see that you gradually will make an increasement in turnover. And if that's the case, and we still take then, again, 40% of your turnover, more money goes from the clinic to us. And also in the end, you can have a higher salary raise and a higher salary, of course. But in the end, the only one who is responsible for that is you. So if you do well in the clinic, you will automatically also see it back in the salary also what you will be earning. But again, guys, now I'll tell you this in summary. Yeah? So if you really would like to know more how it really works, yeah, and also what you can expect every month, but also what are your salaries perspectives also for the 3 years when you're working here in the Netherlands, then let us know. And then we also can have a personal conversation as well. But in the end, you decide how much, yeah, how much money you make yourself. Philippe says, what is the average of the salary that we'll earn already including all the previous costs? It depends on the clinic that we work in, or is it just a general amount for those who join BGB? Good question. Actually, it simply depends on what you do yourself in the clinic. Eh? So you are working in the clinic, you are producing every day an amount for the clinic, you're making a turnover. And the end of the month, we'll send an invoice of 40% of the turnover you've made over there. And with that, we give you the money. We give you the salary, what we have agreed before. It's also good to know that, again, you will know in advance the salary scale which you will be earning when you go to the Netherlands. And when you are working here in the Netherlands, we also will discuss them with you, maybe a possible salary raise if we see that you have been doing well in the clinic, that your turnover has been increasing. So in the end, it's a fixed thing. So it's 40%. Let me check. There are shorter programs. Yes, good question from Laura. For dentists who have not any knowledge of Dutch at all, so we have level zero in Dutch, until starting your career finally in the Netherlands, that's pretty much about it, what we can offer. So 20 weeks, what you need to have. What we also have seen is a good period of time and also possible time that you can have in order to reach the required level of Dutch. Again, knowing the requirements, what we're looking for. So you need to have then good language skills in order to join a program. That's also definitely possible. However, dentists who already have a certain level of Dutch, so let's say you already have level A1 or A2 or B1, then you can maybe skip, and that's also happening quite often, by the way, then you can skip already a few blocks. So maybe if you already have level A1, you can skip the first block. If you have a level A2, you can also skip the second block. And logically, then you don't need 20 weeks studying in the language course, but also less. That can also have effect on the contract. So if we see that in the end, we need to do less for you. So we need to help you with less things than compared with other dentists. In the end, we need to invest less in you. So in the end, also the clinic will have to invest less in you to pay for your costs. So in other words, in that case, maybe we can find out if it won't be a contract of 36 months, maybe a little bit shorter, for example, 30 months. But again, that is very personal. And we have to find out ourselves also together with you then, like what kind of personal offer we can make you. And if it's also, of course, of your agreement and also with mutual agreement or not. But that's something, if you have a certain level of Dutch, let us know. And then we can find out how we can help you as well. That's, by the way, also the reason why we are also helping dentists in the Netherlands, who also, for some reason, they would like to take a language exam with us, or they need to do a language exam still in order to get the registration in the Netherlands over here. Also, if they already have a certain level of Dutch, we can also offer classes here in the Netherlands, only when they already have level B1 in Dutch. Otherwise, if not, it will be like this way, part online and a part offline in Austria. But again, as always, if you have more questions about that, let us know and we can also answer personal questions about that. Is the program, it's a question from Antonio again, I think, is the program suited for those of us who want to join after post-graduation? Yes, of course. Yeah, and even you decide also when it's the right time to start your career in the Netherlands. So it can maybe be the case that you already have done enough. And that's then Rita's also responsibility to find out if it's already enough to come to the Netherlands right away after graduation. But if you are studying still in Portugal or you're doing a master and you prefer to do or you prefer to come to the Netherlands afterwards, also fine. It's also good to know that sometimes dentists, they're also studying besides working in the Netherlands. Depends per the type of master, the type of post-graduation what you're doing, but it's also possible that you can combine your full-time job in the Netherlands with a master abroad, a master in the weekend or part-time. However, keep in mind that it shouldn't affect your work. So that's something what is important.
Especially now with the traveling restrictions.
Exactly. Yeah. So if it's, if you find maybe a very nice online one, even better. Yeah. Yeah. It's a new question. Does BGB, also from a father. Let me check. Nice guys. Thanks for those questions. We always like that. Do B2B have internship programs? Occasionally, usually we don't. And that's again also because usually clinics, they already are very busy themselves, because they all the time have a lot of full agendas. And also they need every personnel to attend the patients that are going to the clinic. Sometimes there is like an internship. And so for students who are still studying, we can find out if there's a clinic able to offer you, to show you how they work over here, to show you how they work with dentistry in the clinic. But usually it's quite difficult to find something. But if you're really looking for something, we can always try if there's a clinic at that moment able to offer something like that. But it's not something, unfortunately, that we can guarantee. So we're firstly... unfortunately it's not something that we can guarantee or something,
and you will always need a language,
and exactly. So also then you're still then something with the language, because in the end the clinic they also speak Dutch, so if you already have a certain level of Dutch, who knows, case. But again, it's quite difficult, but again not impossible, but then let us know if we can find out something. Let me check, guys. Does BGB recruit? That's a question from Mateus. Only general dentists, or do you also seek out more specialized workers? In general, only general dentists. And that's also where you will begin with in the beginning when you start to work in a Dutch dental clinic. However, also what I've heard from several clinics is that also in the end, specialization is always rewarded. So if you really would like to focus on an area of dentistry, I have heard something about that, but I think also Rita knows more about it as well later. In the end, the clinic also will support it. So it's also possible that maybe, for example, if you like to focus yourself more on endodontics or implantology or crown and bridge, etc., that maybe you are developing yourself in those kind of treatments, maybe during a post-graduation or a master, that maybe after a while, you do general dentistry in the morning and then in the afternoon you do your specialization. That's also definitely possible. However, recruiting dentists like from Portugal to the Netherlands usually is general dentists, because those have the most vacancies right now. Sometimes orthodontists, but still then it's
a problem of recognition.
Exactly. Because orthodontics is also different. It's also one of our specializations here in the Netherlands as well. You can work as a general dentist who's doing orthodontic treatments.
Yeah.
And that's also quite doable for general dentists.
But still, it's very bureaucratic in terms of recognition of diplomas.
It is.
Not from us company, but from...
No, from the orthodontic association as well. And even if you would like to really be an exclusive orthodontist, then it's even more harder sometimes. And you really need then a master and 2 years of work experience first, before you can start your registration as orthodontist over here. So that is more complicated. So to answer your question, Mateus, I would say it's especially, I think right now, general dentist. However, if you have a special interest in something, it doesn't mean that you can't do those treatments, of course. So that's also something what the clinic also can help you with. So if you really like endos, well, Rita knows that more about it than me, but of course the clinic can also assign patients with you if they need to do an endo. And then
from
other colleagues, of course, to you, that's always possible. But in general, especially general dentists, that's also where we're looking for. Thank you, I see from the other ones. Nice. is it possible to leave? Nice question from Francisca. Is it possible to leave the Netherlands after 3 years and then return and still be guided by BGB? Yes, for sure. So what also is happening is that we have a collaboration of 3 years. And after the 3 years, it's totally up to you if you would like to continue with us or if you would say, hey guys, thank you for everything. Now I will go totally on my own. Also possible. However, we also, of course, have in the last years, built up a client network. Yeah? So we also know where our dems are working. So if you are happy with that, and also because also a part of what we're doing is also doing your administration. If you say, hey, you know what? If I can only focus on doing my patients, doing my work, and on the background, also my administration will be done, will be arranged. We can also help you with that. So in that way, if you, after 3 years, return and then go back to the Netherlands, we can still maybe continue helping you also with this way of working, this collaboration, or maybe in another way as well. In the end, our goal is simply to help dentists to work here in the Netherlands. So if it's also after that you have been returned to Portugal, you come back to the Netherlands and you contact us again, welcome at any time, of course. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, those are the questions, I think.
Yeah.
Well, guys, I'm again doing almost like a monologue, so I'm almost there. let me check. Yeah, the experience of Rita. So now I will give the word again to Rita.
Oh, now I can talk.
In Portuguese, yeah.
Eu vou falar em português. Eu já estou na Holanda há quase 8 anos. Eu trabalhei 5 anos em Portugal e depois decidi vir para a Holanda. Eu trabalhei como médica dentista generalista em Portugal, trabalhava 6 dias por semana, ou melhor, tinha que ir à clínica 6 dias por semana, estava muitas horas na clínica, mas trabalhava pouco, e trabalhava e só fazia certo tipo de tratamentos, nomeadamente endodontia e pediatria, que é o que dá muito trabalho e dá pouco dinheiro. Isto não é motivante, não é? Uma pessoa faz um curso, tira um curso e quer ajudar um paciente com os problemas que tem e não é só para fazer determinado tipo de tratamentos, por isso é que eu decidi vir para a Holanda. Quando cheguei cá, o que eu pensei, ao fim de pouquinho tempo, pensei que podia ter vindo mais cedo, porque vi em curto, num curto período de tempo, vi uma evolução imensa naquilo que desenvolvi, no meu tipo de trabalho, no tipo de conhecimento, e pensei, pronto, podia ter vindo mais cedo, não é? Mas pronto, isso a pessoa vem no momento em que vem. A nível de trabalho, como é que é o nosso dia de trabalho normal? Trabalha-se de segunda a sexta, o Aaron já tinha dito, começamos geralmente às 8 da manhã, acabamos geralmente às 5 da tarde. Os holandeses são muito pontuais. Portanto, começar às 8 implica que é mesmo começar...
Punctual.
Às 8 o paciente está a entrar ou já está a sentar. Às 5 da tarde, é óbvio que é assim, nós tratamos pacientes, não tratamos papéis. É óbvio que há tratamentos que demoram um bocadinho mais, ou o paciente reage de outra maneira e a agenda atrasa. Mas o último paciente não está marcado para às 5 da tarde, está marcado antes. O que é que nós fazemos também? Fazemos de tudo um pouco. As consultas são marcadas por controle, o paciente vai fazer um check-up, são consultas geralmente curtinhas, em que nós fazemos o raio-x se necessário, fazer a avaliação e fazemos um plano de tratamento. E depois decidimos o que é que tem que acontecer, em quanto tempo é que tem que acontecer posteriormente. O tipo de pacientes... Novos, remediados e velhinhos, pessoas com menos possibilidades, pessoas com possibilidades, faz-se de tudo um pouco. E era como a Aaron tinha dito, há pessoas que têm possibilidade de querer fazer uma coroa, pronto, fazemos uma coroa. Outras pessoas que não têm possibilidades, olha, temos que fazer uma extração, não tenho dinheiro para pagar uma desvitalização. Mas isto é muito dinâmico e exige de nós... saber de tudo um pouco, por isso é que precisamos de generalistas e dentistas que saibam fazer um bocadinho de tudo, não é? Em relação a trabalhar aos fins de semana, na Holanda os médicos dentistas são obrigados a prestar serviço de urgência, as clínicas de uma maneira geral não estão abertas ao fim de semana, pode haver uma clínica ou outra que trabalha ao fim de semana, ou que trabalha por turnos e trabalha num horário mais tardio, mas isto são mais as exceções. Relativamente ao serviço de urgência, é distribuído no início do ano, imaginando na região do Porto. Eu sou do Porto, vamos falar da região do Porto. Aqueles pacientes, durante um ano, vão ser distribuídos pelas clínicas todas da região do Porto. Imaginando que há 100 clínicas na região do Porto, 365 dias são divididos pelas 100 clínicas. E se uma clínica tiver 10 dentistas, esse serviço de urgência também é distribuído por esses dentistas. Ou seja, não quer dizer que se eu trabalhar este sábado, não quer dizer que da próxima vez que houver urgência vou ser eu a trabalhar nesse sábado. E aí será outro colega. Mas todos nós, pronto, temos que prestar este serviço de urgência. Isto é uma versão assim muito resumida do que é o dia de trabalho de um dentista. Se tiverem alguma pergunta específica, também podem colocar e assim também posso responder. Relativamente ao trabalho, nós trabalhamos sempre com uma assistente. Isso também é importante saber. Em Portugal trabalhava, em algumas clínicas trabalhava sem assistente, aqui é sempre com assistente. A nível de protocolos, o que nós aprendemos em Portugal e aqui, eu não notei diferença nenhuma. Como eu aprendi e como se trabalha aqui, é exatamente igual. A nível de materiais, é igual. Não se trabalha com a versão pobre do compósito ou a versão melhor do compósito. Não, de uma maneira geral, trabalha-se com bons materiais. Se me perguntam, as clínicas têm sempre CAD/CAM? Não. Nem todas têm CAD/CAM. Muitas das clínicas têm um microscópio. Mas não quer dizer que todas tenham microscópio, mas de uma maneira geral as clínicas têm tudo que nós precisamos. As agendas estão cheias, temos muito trabalho. No início somos nós que determinamos, no início não, somos sempre nós que determinamos o tempo de cada consulta. É tido em consideração que vocês no início trabalham um bocadinho mais devagar, mas é suposto vermos uma evolução. Vocês na faculdade demoram uma hora para fazer um tratamento, isso não é viável.
Can I talk about the time of the treatment?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Então eu vou falar um bocadinho sobre isso. É óbvio que nós temos em consideração que vocês quando saem da faculdade não sabem fazer de tudo, trabalham lentamente, mas é como disse, demorar uma hora para fazer uma restauração aqui não dá, não é? Há tantos pacientes, as agendas estão tão cheias, nós queremos dentistas que sejam capazes de fazer uma restauração em meia hora, 40 minutos no máximo. Uma primeira sessão de endo, uma hora no máximo. Percebem isto? E depois, com as minhas entrevistas pessoais, eu também faço estas perguntas. Vocês têm que fazer, pensar para vocês mesmos, vocês sentem-se à vontade e conseguem fazer este tipo de trabalho neste período de tempo ou não? Sentem-se capazes de, sozinhos, de ver um paciente e determinar o que é que aquele paciente precisa e dominar a situação? Ou ainda não estão confortáveis com os conhecimentos, com o tipo de trabalho? Isso vocês têm que fazer essa pergunta a vocês próprios, não é? Pronto, mas isto é uma versão muito resumida. Vamos passar à frente e depois, se houver perguntas, voltamos aqui.
Yes. Okay.
You understand?
Yeah,
no, okay.
Almost
crashing. Okay.
Nice. By the way, I was just thinking a little bit when Rita was talking. I just mentioned, by the way, the minimum salaries of a really well-aware dentist. So that doesn't mean anything that everyone is working with that salary, of course. Again, we'll make. We determine together the salary, also, of course, what you are looking for in another country. What do you have in mind yourself? And based on our experiences, and also based on what Rita thinks, also about your dental skills, we come to a salary scale what we think is also, conform your profile, what you have. That's also why it can be starting from 2 up to, 3, 4 and more, depending again on the profile, also what you have.
Also applies to people with more experience.
Yeah, of course.
I can have 10 years of experience, he as well, but I know how to do everything. And he only does, I don't know, a specific type of treatment. I can offer more to the clinic than him. So
my salary can be better than his.
Exactly. And that's also why we have those conversations to find out like what has been your experience and what have you already done in the clinic, and also what is a good salary to start with. So in the end, to make sure that you can handle the amount of patients in the clinic, that you are happy over there, and also, of course, happy with the payment which you get, of course, logically, every month. But again, we can always speak also in person about that, also what you are looking for, and if you also have questions or doubts about that.
Can I say something very fast about salary?
Course. Yeah.
That's a question that you always ask me. Is the salary, even if it's low as a first-year dentist, is it enough to live here?
Oh,
it's enough.
Yeah.
The salary that you receive, it's enough to pay a house. Of course, if you want to live in a mansion, probably not even my salary.
No.
Like to
drive
a Porsche.
I see your house, Rita, over here. Sorry. But
I work for several years.
Yeah,
no,
that's
but,
right. Yeah.
But you can pay a house. You can go to the gym. No, no one goes to the gym. You can go to the restaurant. No one goes to the restaurant.
No, right. No,
but
no.
You have money enough to live, and not like in Portugal, just to pay the bills and survive until the end of the month. No, it's not like that.
Exactly. And depending, of course, on the area where you live, logically, the bigger cities, I think it's the same with Porto and Lisbon in Portugal as well. Logically, cities like Amsterdam, Rotterdam, and The Hague are usually more expensive compared with other areas in the Netherlands. That's also what you can see in the amount of the monthly cost what you have to pay. So that's why we always say we also have a specific document about that. So again, if you would like to have more insights about that, let me know as well. We only think between 1100 and 1500 euros, what you need to have as an indication of the total monthly cost what you need to pay. So
water, electricity,
Netflix, groceries, Amazon Prime, things like that. So everything which you need, groceries obviously as well. But there again, you can also, you have your own lifestyle about that. You have people who go all the time to a very fancy one every week, and you pay literally also the price for that. Or you can go, do you have Lidl in Portugal?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Which is a very good supermarket.
Over here as well. And the quality is also...
It's my favorite.
Also mine as well. So it has also good quality. And also you sometimes even pay literally the half of it. So in the end, it's also up to you, like, where do you usually go for your groceries? And also what do you really need for your monthly cost in the end? But in any case, of course, we wouldn't offer this whole program if we wouldn't be sure that you can have a good living over here. Keep in mind that maybe in the beginning, and then I especially then refer to recently right away the dentist again. Let's say you come to the Netherlands and you just start your career as a dentist, and you just start to earn your first salaries in the Netherlands over here. Don't expect that you will earn directly a big amount of money. No, that's not in the beginning the case, especially in the first months. It will be sometimes quite hard. Keep in mind about that. Like, okay, you go to a new culture where, I don't know if you have spoken about that, about the climate, where the climate is, of course, the weather is sometimes a little bit different than you are used to have in Portugal. I know that with my own experience. The food is a little bit different. So it also will require and also will be a period of adaptation in the Netherlands. But I think that's also common and also normal for everyone. When you're going to a new country, you need some time to adapt, to relocate yourself, to find your place. And then step for step, you'll earn higher salaries, you save more money, and you're making, again, a life and a career in a country where you feel comfortable, I think. What in the end also will contribute to quality of life, after all. Finally, guys, in this final slide, we have in more than 1.5 hours, we have thrown you a lot of information and overwhelmed you with a lot of details about the Netherlands, about our program, about who we are as a company, but also about what you need to know as if you're still studying right now, but also what you need to know as a Portuguese dentist, thinking about maybe a career in the Netherlands. Still then, there will be a replay of this webinar, so we definitely also will send a replay afterwards, so you can listen again to what we have discussed today. But again, if you would like to have, if you have more questions or more personal doubts or more personal questions what we haven't mentioned in this conversation yet, get in touch with me, get in touch or with Rita. So I think very nice that maybe you will speak maybe once with Rita just to have a conversation between two colleague Portuguese dentists, because in the end, I'm from the Netherlands. I'm a typical Dutch guy, but in the end, I really think it's even nice to hear it from the mouth of someone who's from your own country. And besides Rita, we also have a few Portuguese ambassadors. I already mentioned one in this conversation. His name is also João. He's also one of our ambassadors, and you can find our ambassadors also at the website, by the way. But if you would like to speak with one of our ambassadors, like, again, those are dentists who have done the whole process, also like what we have explained in this conversation, themselves as well. They joined our program, and they are living and working here for quite some time already in this country. In our country. So if you would like to hear their experiences, we, by the way, I just invented that at the moment. We also made a video about one of our ambassadors. Her name is Carolina. We made a video about her. You can also find it at our website. Yeah, exactly, in our social media channels. Feel free also to let me know if you would like to contact also one of our ambassadors first, just to hear if they are happy. I think they are, but
they're
also
still here.
Yeah, they're still here. But also, in case that you find out and come to the conclusion, hey, maybe it's still not our country. Also, totally understandable. In the end, it's not for everyone. About the selection process, if you say, hey, this sounds interesting, or I'm still studying and I would like to know more, in the end, again, everyone decides their own moment when is the right time to move to the Netherlands, also together with us. So let's say you would like to know more about it, or you are thinking about making this adventure making this adventure happening for you. Let me know, let Rita know, and we can schedule a conversation with each other. Then again, I will go through, chronologically again, the steps that I have made, not again in 2 hours, but more or less in summary what we have explained also in this conversation. And then step for step, I can also value your profile, and we come then to the conclusion if we can collaborate also with each other. And then gradually, also you go to another conversation with one of my other colleagues, again with Rita, about your dental skills, and then hopefully, yeah, we can welcome you to our program, to the Netherlands. So again, here you also find our contact details, our email addresses, but we also are active on LinkedIn and also on Instagram. See way better than I do, actually, but I'm also active also on that. So feel free to reach out to us and also to ask any question which you still have. So guys, I hope that in these 1 hour and 46 minutes, we have given you a nice impression about the Netherlands in general, but also about who we are as a company, and also how we could help you with your relocation from Portugal to the Netherlands. And I hope this was useful for you to hear, and hopefully to see you very soon. Are there more questions, maybe, for now? Let me check. I think that everything is quite still clear. Actually, no, there are no questions, I think, for now.
People want lunch.
Yeah. Well, guys, again, from here, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And
yeah.
Thank you very much for your time. And again, the webinar also will have a replay. Oh, wait a minute. There's one question, I think. Only thank you. Hey, nice. No, thank you, guys. A pleasure. And again, there will be a webinar replay coming of this webinar. So they also will be sent to you. Hopefully we can see each other soon again. And for now, we wish you like a nice weekend.
Bon fin de semana.
Yeah, bon fin de semana.
Bon fin de semana.
Good weekend. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.